Good morning to another present here. Today we are going to see about operational amplifier, which is unit 1 of LIC. So op amp is an high gain DC amplifier. Basically it is used in the basic building block of analog electronic circuits. Amplifiers are linear devices that have all the properties required for nearly IC DC amplification, and therefore used extensively in signal conditioning, filtering, and perform the mathematical operations such as addition, subtraction, and integration and differentiation. It is having three terminals. One is inverting input and non-inverting input, and another one is the final output. So inverting input we are simply called as negative sign, and non-inverting input it is represented as positive sign. If you are giving the input to the inverting input, output must be 180 degree out of phase with the input. If you are giving to the non-inverting input, without any phase changes we are getting the output. And the third terminal will be our output. We can able to get the output. For example, if we take multiplication or amplification of a given signal, if an op amp is used as an amplifier, either we can give the input to the inverting input or to the non-inverting input. For example, if we are using inverting input as the input signal for amplification of the signal, so the output will be 180 degree out of phase with the input signal. So there are different types of op amp. One is for summing amplification and subtraction, integrator, and it can be used for differential amplifiers. Why we go for operational amplifier? Relatively we can take big signals. If you want to get strong signals, we can go for operational amplifiers which can amplify the signal with a high gain. Either we can get an inverting input or an non-inverting output. For example, it can be used in addition, subtraction, and differentiation. For example, if we go for the summing amplification may be done either by using three signals, four signals, etc. In this course we can able to take three inputs. So inputs are V1, V2, and V3. That is given to the non-inverting terminal, and the non-inverting terminal is grounded. So grounded means it is 0 volt. We can able to give the input to V1, V2, and V3, and it is amplified. We can get the output at the Vout. For example, if I take the current at the feedback resistor, that is IF, it is a combination of I1 plus I2 plus I3. So we know I equal to V by R, so V1 by R1 plus V2 by R2 plus V3 by R3. Here, instead of using R1, R2, R3, we are using R input. So finally, we are inverting the equation. V out is equal to minus RF by RN into V input. So the output can be RF by R1 into V1 plus RF by RN into V2 plus RF by RN for V3. So we can get the output for the three inverting inputs in terms of negative, because we are giving the input to the inverting terminal, so you are getting an inverting amplifier. So the output of the summing amplifier equation is given below in the PowerPoint. So this can be performed by using a problem. Determine the output voltage for the summing amplifier shown in the figure. So similarly, the resistance value R1, R2, R3 are given, and the feedback resistor RF is given. We know the formula for inverting amplifier: minus RF by R1 into V input. With that we can able to calculate for V1, V2, V3, and finally we can able to calculate it for V output. Thank you.